This is the first video of my video series on running a regression using SPSS. Identifying outliers is one of the initial steps in data preparation before performing a regression analysis. An outlier simply means an unusual observation or an extreme value. This refers to the observations that lie substantially far away from most of the other observations. For example, assume that almost all students in a class have heights between 150 to 175 centimeters. However, assume that only one student has a height of 200 centimeters. In this case, this observation looks like an extreme or unusual observation since it is not very common for a student in that class to have such a height. As illustrated in this histogram, we can see that this observation is far away from the other observations. In SPSS, we can use both histogram and box plots to identify outliers. Just now, in the student height example, I showed how to see whether there are outliers in a dataset using a histogram. However, with this, it is difficult to identify specifically which row in our dataset contains this extreme value. Therefore, the box plot, also known as box and whisker plot, is my favorite technique for identifying outliers. Box plots show how our observations are spread. Let's see how to identify outliers in dataset using box plots in SPSS. I use IBM SPSS version 20 for this demonstration. I have this dataset in SPSS containing return on equity of a sample of 100 firms for year 2019. The easiest way to generate a box plot is to first click Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and then click Explore. In this dialog box, select relevant variable, in our case ROE, and move it to dependent list. Then click Plots and make sure that factor levels together is selected. For comparison, I will check histogram as well. Uncheck all other checkboxes so that our output is clear. Then click Continue. Again, to make the output clearer, I will select Plots under Display instead of Both. Then click OK. If required, we can select more than one variable here. If so, box plots will be generated for each variable separately. Then we can see our box plot and histogram. Let's see how to interpret the box plot. This line represents the median of our variable. The shaded area of the box represents the interquartile range. This upper boundary is the Q3 and this lower boundary is the Q1. These two boundaries of the box are usually called hinges. Approximately 50% of the observations lie within the box or between these two hinges. These two whiskers, also called as inner fences, show the lowest and highest data points. For example, when there are no outliers, this upper end of the whisker indicates the maximum observation, while this lower end of the whisker indicates the minimum observation. In this example, there are no outliers. And the histogram looks similar to the bell-shaped normal distribution. However, in case there are outliers, SPSS adds 1.5 times the interquartile range to Q3 to calculate this maximum boundary, and subtracts 1.5 times interquartile range from Q1 to calculate this minimum boundary. Any observations beyond this range is identified as an outlier. If the observations are normally distributed, around 95% of the observations are expected to lie within these inner fences. This is why box plot has a close relationship with the histogram. For example, if I plot histogram and box plot side by side, it looks like this. SPSS uses two symbols to indicate outliers on the box plot. A small circle is used to indicate a moderate outlier. Moderate outliers lie within 1.5 times to 3 times the interquartile range in either side. If an observation lies beyond 3 times the interquartile range in either side, a star is used to indicate such outlier. Let's look at another variable with some outliers. In my dataset, I have a variable named ROE with outliers. This is an exact copy of the previous variable. However, I have changed the 13th observation to 3 and the 26th observation to 2.5 for this demonstration. All other 98 observations are exactly same as those in ROE. Now let's look at how our box plot and histogram change due to this alteration in data. We can see both histogram and box plot has taken very different shapes merely as a result of the changes made to two observations. Earlier, the histogram looked almost normally distributed, but now it looks like heavily skewed. These two detached bars signal the existence of potential outliers. In the box plot, we can clearly see that two observations lie outside the inner fences, one marked with a small circle and the other marked with a star. As mentioned before, observation number 26 has been identified by SPSS as a moderate outlier, while observation number 13 has been identified as an extreme outlier. You know that for normally distributed data, the mean is always equal to the median. However, due to outliers, the mean is usually dragged away from the median. Similar distortion may occur in most of the other statistics as well. This results in a distorted picture of the reality. Therefore, once an outlier is identified, something needs to be done on it. We can take one of four actions. Action 1. We can leave the outlier as it is. Especially when it is a moderate outlier, this can be an option. However, researchers' knowledge on the variable and its observations play a key role in determining whether we can leave it or take some other action on it. Action 2. We can correct it. There can be errors in measurement and data entry, and the outlier can be a result of such error. So, we can check whether an error has been occurred during the data entry or measurement. If such error can be identified, correct it in the dataset. Action 3. We can winsorize it. This means bringing the outlier up or down to match with the minimum or maximum indicated by the whisker boundaries or with some other recommended values. This reduces the effect of outliers. Action 4. We can remove it. Especially when there is no reasonable justification to leave it or when the observation is an extreme outlier, the only option available may be to remove it from the dataset or exclude it from the analysis. In case of action 3 and 4, we need to mention how we cleaned our data in the research report to maintain transparency. Assume that in this example, I decided to remove these two outliers. One way to remove these outliers is to delete the relevant rows from the dataset. However, this is not so appropriate since this action will permanently delete those observations from our dataset. Therefore, instead of deleting the rows, I will use my filter variable called filter to remove the outliers from subsequent analysis. Initially, I have entered 1 in all rows under filter variable. Now, I will enter 0 for 13th and 26th observation. And then click data, select cases. In the dialog box, I will select use filter variable and move variable called filter here. And then click OK. Then on the dataset, we can see that row 13 and 26 has been crossed off. Later, if we want to analyze all observations, we can click data, select cases. In the dialog box, I will select all cases here. Then in the subsequent analysis, all observations will be considered. Let's generate the box plot and histogram after deselecting 13th and 26th observations. Now, we can see a cleaner box plot and more normally distributed histogram again. Remember, only thing that we just did is to remove 13th and 26th observations from our plots. In summary, once we properly deal with outliers, our box plots and histogram looks better and the dataset becomes more suitable for subsequent analysis. Anyway, this technique is used to identify univariate outliers. I will discuss about identifying multivariate outliers in a separate video.